Meanwhile, tourism experts and ordinary citizens give mixed reactions to the Philippine government's new tourism slogan, Love the Philippines. Alvin El Chico tells us more.
In 2002, it's Wow Philippines. It's More Fun in the Philippines clicked in 2012. This year, the country's new tourism slogan is Love the Philippines. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco says the word love is always associated with the Philippines and the country is on top of the list of places loved by tourists. But for some experts, the new slogan is not quite catchy.
It's quite underwhelming, especially with compared to, yun nga, it's more fun in the Philippines. Para siyang utos. Kumbaga, shortcut na niya yung thought process na nilid ka kagad niya na mahalin mo ang Pilipinas. And to a certain extreme, it almost sounds like we're begging.
It should be paired with a beautiful jingle, something that's very musical because, you know, Filipinos are very good in music. So I'm sure there's going to be one Filipino who can compose a beautiful jingle.
Some ordinary people like the line Love the Philippines, but others are not that impressed, preferring the previous tagline.
Sakto lang. It's too generic. Hindi siya catchy eh. Lalo sa mga ibang, lalo pag i-market natin siya sa labas ng Philippines.
Mas okay yung dati. It's more fun in the Philippines.
It's more fun in the Philippines. Parang you're just there to have fun. Pero love the Philippines. You're there to appreciate culture namin, country namin, at love yung whole country itself. Hindi lang fun lang.
For former Senator and Tourism Secretary Richard Gordon, the new campaign line is good, but it needs to be coupled with good infrastructure and system to impress tourists and make them go back to the Philippines.
Ingatan natin yung airport. Pagka madumi o namamatay yung ilaw, napaka-basic lang eh. Yung paligid natin malinis palagi. Yung pagbati natin, hindi natin tinitignan na mark yung tourist. Ako, pagkakataon na ito, oh, may pera ito, overpriced natin.
Meanwhile, less than a day after the new tourism slogan was launched, Albay Representative Joey Salceda complained about the alleged non-inclusion of Albay or Bicol in the campaign. In a Facebook post, Salceda has asked Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco why there is no love for Albay, no love for Bicol, then declared that Albay tourism will thrive even without help from the department. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Finance Chief Benjamin Jokno projects inflation will further ease in the coming months. Jokno says the inflation rate could hit below 4% by September or October this year. That's the top end of government's 2-4% target range. Last month, the consumer price index slowed for the fourth straight month at 6.1% as fuel, transport costs, and prices of some food products eased.
Ang bagong forecast ng BSP is 5.5 for the whole year. So we continue to monitor it on a monthly basis, baka mas bumaba pa. Ang ano niyan talaga yung meat at saka yung energy is going down. Siguro yung meat pa lang, problema pa rin yung ASF.
Despite the easing of prices in some food products, the government is pursuing higher taxes on salty foods and sweetened beverages. This, it says, is to address illnesses related to poor diet. But Jokno says he's in favor of exempting instant noodles from the proposed tax scheme, noting the impact on lower income families.
Alam mo, inaaral pa ng Department of Health yan eh, which products yung may threshold na ganito. So I cannot specifically say. Siguro most of the mga chichirias na salty talaga, di ba? Ay, makikita mo naman salt content nung sa...
Yeah, nakalagay. Sodium.
Sodium. I would say na hindi siguro dapat isama yung Lucky Me. Kasi that's ano yung pangmasa talaga.
Universal and commercial banks will no longer be able to use enterprise loans as an alternative to compliance with the reserve requirement. The Philippine Central Bank announced that Wednesday as it prepares to unwind the relief measures imposed during the height of the pandemic. Now, the BSP's order covered loans to micro, small, and medium-sized enterprises, as well as large enterprises to soften the impact of the health crisis on their businesses. This development will coincide with a reduction in the reserve requirement ratio of local banks by 250 basis points, which will take effect on June 30.
The use of generative artificial intelligence such as ChatGPT could boost productivity in the business process outsourcing or BPO industry. That's according to the Contact Center Association of the Philippines, as it sought to allay fears AI could lead to job losses. CCAP said AI can help reduce transaction time, improve customer experience, and raise the productivity of workers. CCAP President Miki Ocampo said the actual impact of AI could be reflected in the industry's figures in the next few years. Revenues of the Philippines' IT BPM sector is expected to hit $59 billion by 2028 with the help of AI. In 2022, revenues came in at $32 billion.
And before we go, another historic day in Philippine television as ABS-CBN signs partnership deals with its rival networks TV5 and GMA. The details from Ganyal Krishna.
ABS-CBN has entered into another content agreement with TV5, strengthening that partnership and ensuring delivery of high-quality entertainment to Filipino viewers. Present during the signing of the contract are ABS-CBN Executives Chairman Mark Lopez, President and CEO Carlo Katigbak, Chief Operating Officer for Broadcast Cory Vidanes, and Head of Finance Operations Kat Lopez. Representing TV5 are MediaQuest Holdings Chairman Manny Pangilinan, MediaQuest Holdings President and CEO Jane Jimenez Basas, TV5 President Guido Saballero, PLDT Head of Business Transformation Victorico Vargas, and TV5 CFO Pierre Paul Buhay. The five-year deal paves the way for TV5 and ABS-CBN to continue providing top-rated programs during the weekday and weekend primetime slots. Some of the ABS-CBN shows that will continue to air on the TV5 network on weekdays are audience favorites, FPJ's Batang Quiapo, The Iron Heart, Dirty Linen, and The Tale of Nokdu. Meanwhile, ABS-CBN's singing variety show Everybody Sing and noontime variety show Asap Natin To will fill the weekend and Sunday slots, respectively. Chairman Mark Lopez said he is very grateful for the partnership with TV5.
It's a partnership which we've been very happy with, and I think there are a lot of opportunities that we can do together. I think we have a lot of programs in store for our audience moving forward. No, so tuloy-tuloy yan. We will make sure that we create the right content for everyone.
Hey, congratulations, Showtime and GTV!
Meanwhile, the Showtime family sealed the deal with GMA Network Wednesday afternoon. Comedian Vice Ganda together with the host of Noontime Variety Show thank GMA Kapuso Network for giving them a chance to continue providing laughter and entertainment to Filipino audiences.
Historical for Philippine TV, di ba? Historical, good news. Ito yung mga klase ng balita na masarap mabasa, masarap mapanood at malaman ng maraming Pilipino kasi it speaks of hope. Diba? May magandang pangyayari sa paligid. It's just so beautiful.
ABS-CBN President and CEO Carlo Katigbak also thanked GMA for opening its doors to ABS-CBN projects.
Katapos po namin i-launch ang Unbreak My Heart, hindi po namin naisip na magkakaroon ng kasunod kaagad ang aming partnership with GMA. So nung nabalitaan namin na gustong ilipat ang time slot ng Showtime, tinawagan namin si Annette para pag-usapan ang posibilidad na mabigyan ng bagong tahanan ng aming programa. Marami pong salamat sa lahat ng aming kapuso sa pagtanggap niyo sa Showtime at sa pagyakap niyo muli sa ABS-CBN.
Cheers!
Gino Krishnan, ABS-CBN News.